Hello, welcome. As many of you have been eagerly anticipating, today we are releasing the first part of the comparison between RPCS3 and Xenia. The initial games chosen were selected by the community and our Patreons. It's worth mentioning that we've previously made exclusive videos on Red Dead Redemption and GTA 4. If you'd like to check them out, I'll leave the links in the video description. If you're interested in a second part of this video or are passionate about the world of emulation, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel to receive 2 new videos every week. Stay tuned for more exciting emulation content.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
Before we begin the video, let's talk a bit about the emulators, RPCS3 and Xenia. For those who are not familiar, RPCS3 is the PlayStation 3 emulator, and to achieve good performance with virtually any game, the most important factor is to have a processor with excellent single-core performance. For Intel, processors from the 12th or 13th generation are recommended. Regarding the GPU, there will hardly be any bottlenecks, even with a GTX 1660, making it possible to play all games at 1080p and even 1440p in some cases. On the other hand, Xenia is the Xbox 360 emulator and follows an opposite path. For the processor, you can use any i5 or i7 that supports AVX2 instruction, such as those from the 4th generation. However, you will need a GPU with excellent performance to run the games properly. Unfortunately, the progress of this emulator is one of the slowest, with many games still having issues with saves and audio. Based on my current system, I'm confident that most games will perform better on Xenia. However, I'll leave my recommendation on which emulator I suggest you use, based on the Steam hardware survey. According to the most used GPUs, we have the GTX 1650 and GTX 1660, and regarding processors, 6-core CPUs are the most popular. For reference, I chose the i5-8400, which is the closest match to these results. Both emulators are configured to run the games at 720p, to make the test more even with unlocked FPS. One of the games that was requested to be tested was Pure Football. Unfortunately, I didn't note down who requested it and I'm not able to locate the message now, but for you who suggested the Pure Football test, here's the only bad news of this video. The game doesn't work on Xenia, so, for now, our only option is to play it on RPCS3. As soon as I loaded the game for the first time, the shaders made the gameplay completely slow, raising the CPU usage to 100%. However, after the game compiled all the shaders, everything works correctly, making the game playable, with only minor issues in the shadows that won't compromise your gameplay. Our second test will be with the game Midnight Club Los Angeles. For those who have already tested this game, they know that it is very problematic on RPCS3 and even on Xenia. However, with the constant updates from Xenia, the game has become playable, even with a GPU that is the minimum requirement of the emulator, like the GTX 980. In comparison, while the RPCS3 version struggles to maintain 20 FPS, in a completely slow and unplayable emulation state, Xenia manages to keep the game above 75 FPS, with CPU usage reaching a maximum of 30% and GPU usage around 80%. It's important to note that this game runs at 30 FPS on the base consoles, and not even on the Xbox Series there is a patch that unlocks native 60 FPS. Therefore, Xenia manages to emulate this game in a way that not even Microsoft's own console can achieve, which is an impressive result. My recommendation for Midnight Club Los Angeles is undoubtedly Xenia. Dante's Inferno is another game exclusive to the consoles of this generation, which EA had no interest in bringing as a remake to any later generation, let alone to PC. For those who think this game is just a copy of God of War, they are mistaken, as Dante's Inferno has a unique story. This is the first game that runs well on both emulators. For those who have seen a previous comparison where I said that Xenia had audio and save issues with this game, know that they have already been fixed. However, if you want to unlock the FPS in this game, Xenia will have uncensored cutscenes between audio and video, while RPCS3 manages to stay synchronized even with unlocked FPS. Regarding the tests, even with more enemies on the screen and in a more open location, Xenia shows a frame rate almost double that of RPCS3. However, performance is not everything. RPCS3's emulation of Dante's Inferno is much more accurate, despite having more stutters. Therefore, I recommend RPCS3, unless you are having performance issues. Now we will test Ninja Gaiden 2. You may be wondering why I am testing this game, as it has native versions for PC. The reason is that, if you have already played the Xbox 360 version of this game, you know that it is the only one that is not censored. All other versions, including the PlayStation 3 one, have censorship regarding violence, for example. Additionally, it's worth noting that the other versions are easier, and that's why I'm testing this game. This game requires a specific configuration in Xenia, which I will leave in the video description. As for the test, Xenia once again outperforms RPCS 3. First, let's talk about RPCS 3. The performance is variable, with points going over 120 FPS, but if the game drops below 60 FPS, it will slow down. RPCS 3 cannot maintain a constant 60 FPS in Ninja Gaiden 2. Another problem frequently presented in the emulator is the loss of video driver and random crashes during the compilation of multiple shaders simultaneously. Meanwhile, in Xenia, the game performs well, with no graphical issues and without the annoying censorship mentioned earlier. Therefore, I definitely recommend using Xenia to play Ninja Gaiden 2. Silent Hill Downpour also runs decently on both emulators, but Xenia presents some minor issues. If you choose to unlock the FPS on Xenia, all textures will become blurred. Therefore, let's compare focusing on 60 FPS. There is a patch in Xenia that allows the game to run with 16x anisotropic filtering, providing better quality for distant textures in open environments. In terms of performance presented with each emulator, in my tests, Xenia had a performance of over 100 FPS compared to RPCS 3, and the low 1% was at 194 FPS on Xenia, compared to 61 FPS on RPCS 3. However, I've read reports that the game may have performance problems in some future area. My recommendation is to use the emulator that you find best according to the CPU and GPU installed in your machine. Call of Duty 3 is a game I had never compared before because I thought it had a port for PC, but it actually doesn't. In this game, vertex explosions occur in Xenia, depending on the angle you're looking at. In RPCS 3, at least in the initial areas, the game runs well, but there are many slowdown problems when loading initial shaders. However, after the compiled shaders are already saved to disk, you can play normally on RPCS 3. It performs better on Xenia, but no one wants to play a game full of graphical defects, so my recommendation is to use RPCS 3. The Darkness, the first game, is very beloved by fans and also does not have a PC port. This game has occlusion and lighting issues in Xenia, but for the most part, it has a higher speed. In RPCS 3, it's been about a year since it became fully playable, which means you can go from the beginning to the end of the game without many problems. Therefore, my recommendation is to use RPCS 3. Street Fighter 2 Turbo HD Remix, a reimagining of Street Fighter 2, also did not have a PC port and runs very well on both emulators. I didn't feel the need to unlock the FPS since it's not a game that will run above 60 FPS under any circumstances. However, I don't recommend either of these two versions. If you want to play this game, I recommend using the Switch version, using Yuzu or Ryujinx, as it's the most complete version, with additional characters. Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls is another game that has a PC port, and it's a very good port, in fact. So why am I testing this game here? Simply because of the ability to play with a controller, cooperative play for up to 4 people, and various features that only the console version can deliver. Previously, this game had issues with saving on Xenia Canary, but now that problem has been resolved, although the game simply doesn't open anymore. However, there is a solution: use Xenia Master. In RPCS 3, the game is still not in a playable state, so random crashes can occur, as it happened during the recording of this video. There is also a version for Switch, but I haven't tested it to say if it's better than the versions presented here. Sonic Unleashed is the Sonic game that Sega still hasn't brought to PC, along with Sonic 2006. This game is still very problematic on both emulators. In RPCS 3, it's very slow and doesn't have decent performance, even if you disable shadows and motion blur. In Xenia, it's still unstable and can experience random crashes at any time, even when using available patches and mods. The last two times I used it on Xenia, there were no random crashes, but as I always say, it's a matter of luck. Some people play for hours without any crash, while others experience frequent crashes. At the moment, I recommend waiting if you want to play this game, as it won't be long before it becomes playable on Xenia. Finally, I tested UFC Undisputed 3, which requires a special configuration for Xenia, which will be in the comments. ZENIAC can deliver up to 3 times the performance in this game. I've done an in-depth analysis of this game in the past. The PlayStation 3 version has up to 5 times the size of the Xbox 360 version's disc, resulting in better texture quality. However, RPCS 3's performance is satisfactory, staying above 60 FPS according to your processor. I don't know if the game has problems with random crashes in other modes, but in free play, everything runs normally. Due to the texture quality, I recommend the RPCS 3 version, but if you feel that your frame rate is low, you should use the Xenia version. It's always better to have 2 options to run the same game. So, folks, that was the video. If you want a part 2, please suggest games, and I'll note down all the suggestions and prepare another video. Also, if this video was helpful for you, don't forget to leave a like and share it in other emulator communities. Until the next video.